At the Yellowstone supervolcano in Wyoming, many people often incorrectly think that the volcano is overdue for an imminent large eruption. This is not the case, as the overall volcano is not showing at depth signs pointing towards a large eruption in the short to moderate term future. However, there is an often overlooked hazard within the national park which is related to volcanic activity which can still be quite deadly. What I am referring to are powerful hydrothermal explosions. Take, for example, the Indian Pond Lake. This lake formed in a powerful hydrothermal explosion in 1350 BC, which carved out a 1,640-foot or 500-meter-wide crater in the ground. The explosion in question ejected car-sized boulders up to 9,840 feet or 3 kilometers distant and created a notable crater rim which can still be seen today. While many more recent smaller hydrothermal explosions have occurred since, such as shown here at the Biscuit Basin, the possibility remains of similarly sized explosions occurring in the future. According to the U.S. Geological Survey, the odds of a 100-meter or larger crater forming in a hydrothermal explosion within Yellowstone National Park is about 1 in 900 each year. To better understand these craters, I will now emphasize the single largest crater in the park. Approximately 14,000 years ago, the 7,300-foot-long and 4,500-foot-wide Mary's Bay crater formed in a powerful explosion. This crater has a highly irregular profile owed in part to its formation occurring from several near-simultaneous explosions instead of one single explosion. Mary's Bay crater represents the single largest hydrothermal crater on the planet, but its origin can be a bit confusing. You see, hydrothermal explosions are ridiculously similar to a type of volcanic eruption called a phreatic eruption. In phreatic eruptions, magma or superheated gases associated with magma directly heat nearby groundwater. This groundwater then flashes to steam, pressure builds, and a powerful explosion occurs. One example of a phreatic eruption is at the Taal volcano in the Philippines on July 1, 2021. While its eruption column primarily consisted of water vapor, it also contained small fragments of magma and volcanic gases. Hydrothermal explosions, on the other hand, occur in areas where magma is present at depth but it does not directly interact with groundwater. Groundwater is heated by residual heat of magma permeating through neighboring rock, which heats it to just below the boiling point. This water then heads towards the surface, where it is periodically ejected through a series of geysers. However, if a cap forms on top of the points which let steam escape, an immense amount of pressure begins to build. If enough time passes, this pressure eventually becomes too great and the ground explodes upwards in a powerful steam explosion. While indirectly caused by volcanic activity, hydrothermal explosions are not considered to be volcanic eruptions. In the case of the Mary's Bay crater, its formation relates to both stress release and a rapid change in the overall level of Yellowstone Lake. As of 16,000 years ago, the Ice Age was still ongoing, and almost all of Yellowstone was buried by 4,000 feet thick of ice. When this ice slowly melted away, the crust rebounded upwards, causing changes in numerous hydrothermal systems. When this pressure was finally released 13,800 years ago, it generated a powerful explosion on the order of at least several hundred kilotons of TNT. A blast wave expanded outwards from the center of the crater, water was ejected several thousand feet into the air, and a tsunami was created on Yellowstone Lake. As hundreds of millions of tons of rock were pulverized, large boulders were thrown high into the air, falling back to the ground at up to 2.5 miles distant. Although several other hydrothermal craters have formed since, none have been quite as large. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Solomon Parker for supporting this channel.